Hey learner, this is Nilesh Porate. Welcome back. So in this video, we are going to show you adding the views functionality to the specific post. Means we keep the track of views that each of your the post is getting. See, there are the multiple posts which are available in my home screen, but we want to keep the how many hit of that the particular post. Means anyone user click on that post, okay, and then see the details of that post or add the one comment in that post. Then we want to keep the track of how many time hit that post, okay. So first we are going to this PHP MyAdmin. This is my CMS database, okay, and category, comments, post, and the user. These are the my different tables. So we are going to the post table. So click on this post. Go to the structure of this post. See, there are the different columns. We add the one more column after this post status. See, add one column after the post status. Go. Now my column name is that the post underscore views underscore count, integer length is that the 11, and my default value is that 0 as defined. This is my default value 0 and the save. See my post, okay. So see, initially my all view count is that the 0, okay. Now see, this is my index homepage, this one index.php file. This is my user homepage, okay. And when we click on the any post, see, assume we click on this CMS project, this is my first post. See, we are going to this post.php file, and this is my post ID 1, okay. So we want to add the code in that post.php file, okay. So this is my bracket editor. So we are going to open the post.php file, this one. This is my code, okay. See, this is my post.php file. This is the if condition. If my post ID is set, then we are going to this if condition, and we display the post detail of that specific post ID, okay. See, this if statement is closed here, okay. And if my post ID is not set, then here we add the one else condition. So we are going to the location again, index.php. If my post ID is not a set, this one. Okay, this is my else block. Then if my post ID is set and we are in if condition here, so we get the post ID, and before displaying the specific post, first we increment the post count. Okay. So here we add the one query, update post set post views count is equal to post views count plus 1, where your post ID is equal to this dollar post ID. Okay, now we want to execute this query, so we copy this code here. Okay, so query was executed, and if query execution is failed, then here display the error message. Okay, so now we test this code. So here we use one comment section to describing code functionality. So increment the post view count, and this one is that the displaying the specific post details. Save. So here we refresh the page again. So this is my index.php. Okay, this is my first post. So see here simultaneously in database. So we refresh the database. See, my post view count is that the zero. All the count is that the zero. Now we click on this first post, CMS project. Okay, now see here, refresh. See, my post count is that the one. We hit the first post. Okay, again we click on this back. Again click on this post. See, refresh. This is my post count 2. Okay, now we click on the another post. So we back. See, second post, click. See here, refresh. So this is my another post. Okay, now when we log in the admin user and we are going to the admin panel, see, this is my view all post section, this one. Now we want to display the post count at the last column of this table. Okay, so we are going to this view all post.php file. So see here in this admin section, includes view all post.php, this one. So we add the one more column here, th count, view count or views. Okay, and in this while loop, after deleting, so we copy this edit section here, and after this delete we copy this echo. Okay, see, my name is that here. We want to add the one more variable to getting the post count here. Here we copy again this variable and we get the post underscore. So see, my column name is that post underscore views underscore count, this one. So we copy this variable and here my value is that the count, and here ahref is equal to post.php, and here reset is equal to post id. We want to reset this post to zero again. So in this last column we display the existing view count, and when we click on this number, then we are going to reset that count to zero. Okay, so here we use the reset variable and pass this post specific post id. Now we test that the table, how the table is look. So save these changes and see here, view all post. Now we zoom out this column. So check it again. So this tr is closed after this echo. Okay, so again view all post. Okay, perfect. So here we again zoom into 100. Now this is my recent post first. Okay, so for testing purpose we increment the count for the post id 1 and the 3, this one, and we displaying the post in descending order. So recent post is displaying first. So see here at the bottom of this page, my post id is that the 1 and the 2. Okay, now when we click on this number, then we are going to this post.php file and pass the post ID to this reset variable. Okay, so now like the delete code, we do the same functionality in the reset. Okay, so see here at the bottom of this page, see this is my delete if condition. So we copy this delete if and paste here one more time. Now my get value is that the reset, this is my post ID, reset post ID, and here we use the update query. So update post set post views count is equal to 0, where my post ID is equal to reset post ID, this one. Now we execute this query and we again going to this post.php file. Okay, now we save these changes and test the code. So see here at the bottom of this page, when we click on this two number, then see at the bottom of this page there is error. Write syntax use the near at line 1, SQL syntax query fail line number 138, this one. So here dollar underscore get, we get the value. So my get name is that the reset. Okay, so again we refresh this page back. Okay, so when we click on this again 2, see at the bottom of this page my counter was reset 0. Again we click on this 1, see my counter was reset. Okay, so there is one minor change is that when we are going to this home site, see this is my start bootstrap first link. When we click on this link, then there is no functionality. Okay, so we add the one link at this cmsindex.php file, this one. Okay, and we change the name also. So see here, this is my index.php file. So again we are going to this navigation.php file, this one, and see this is the start bootstrap. We change the name is that CMS front and pass the link is that index.php. So see here, so when we are click on this specific post and again we click on this CMS front, okay, we are redirected to this index.php file. Okay, fine. Now here we are finishing this view count functionality. So in next video we do the pagination section. So we add the page number of this index.php file, this one. Okay, so till if you have the any queries, then comment on our query in comment box. Like and subscribe the channel. See you on next video. Bye bye.